Baba Avnikant Deo, Avnikant, like you all know him. I have some really amazing memories related to art with my dad from my early childhood. One of them being obviously belonging to a family of artists, Ma, Baba. My house is a studio. It was never really a home. It was always full of sculptures and paintings, easels, paints, brushes. So even before I learned how to walk and I started walking, Baba had given me a canvas and paints to paint with. And I remember holding a brush even before I could hold his hand and learn how to walk. So those are my first memories, big memories in my childhood, where I was born to a painter. In my childhood and while I was growing up, and also now that I have grown up and I understand art, one of the striking things of Baba's paintings have been the colors he uses. I really think the combination of the colors and that, you know, enhances his work is just so beautiful. I am a true admirer of the colors and the color combinations that he uses in his paintings. I think it's really spectacular. And his line drawings and the way he draws women is just really beautiful. I think we all agree to that. But one of the most special works of his that I remember since my childhood, I was really, really young when he was painting that. It's Jukti Tokko Ar Goppo. It's a tiny little fun fact that I'll share with you all. While he was painting it, if you see the painting, you'll know there's Hrithik Ghatok lying on, you know, the wooden plank where he's being carried. So for that, my dad made me the model. So I remember lying down like that for every day, like about 10-15 minutes every day. He would ask me to come and lie down on the couch like that. So I remember lying down like that. I think I was in my, I was really young. I barely remember how old I was at that time. But that painting has a special place because of that specific memory. And when I look at it now, I remember myself lying like that always. But that's my memory from that painting during that time. But now that I've grown up and I've understood what it's about, I think it's beautiful, the thought behind it and the beautiful hibiscus that it has. The painting is dedicated to Hrithik Ghatok. It's based on the last film that he made. So the hibiscus symbolizes Bengal of that time, because we all know that hibiscus is used during Kali Pujo and Kali Badi, and it has this beautiful memory and of Kolkata with it. So Bengal and hibiscus go hand in hand. So that beautiful overpowering image of the hibiscus is the portrayal of Bengal. And there's Nakshalite, there's Hrithik Ghatok lying there,
dead, and he himself carrying his own dead body on his shoulder. Those falling fingers touching the currents of Padma River of East Bengal, where Hrithik Ghatok migrated from. Bleeding heart and boat in Padma River show trauma of partition. Stark black background of the painting signifies dark days of partition and Naxalite movement. Pictorial space is treated with uninhibited freedom.
This painting is one of my most favorite of Baba and from his collection. And of course, over the years, he's done different kinds of works, and it's very difficult to put my finger on one thing and say this is my favorite. But I'm just so glad that I got introduced to art at such an early age. Baba has always been an admirer of cinema, whether it's Satyajit Ray or Hrithik Ghatok, and that's why I feel very, very connected to this particular painting. And I'm glad that I took my steps towards cinema and I'm a part of the Hindi film industry and television industry today, because that's something Baba really, really wanted. And I'm very happy that I'm a part of this film that we are creating together for Baba. And thank you so much. Lots of love to all of you. And he's always with us. His works are going to be with us, and he's always, always going to be with us.